do think that there's, he's right, they're right about talking about some of these divides that are out there. And parts of the problem is that now that everyone has realized that technology is so pervasive in our lives, there's a figure, people are trying to figure out how to focus, how to, in some ways, how to control. And it's difficult to do because it's such a nimble technology, and government doesn't regulate, is not nimble enough to regulate anyway, because it's a years-long process, and technology changes much faster than that. So what you've got right now is while the federal government is trying to come to a consensus on how to approach encryption, the states are trying to come up with their own solutions, and that creates a risk where you can have 50 different solutions in 50 different states. We already have 3 states that I'm aware of. 2 in particular come to mind. California and New York have tried to move forward legislation to require backdoors for encryption. Well, if you've got 50 different standards, you run the risk of having, what, 50 different phones? So I'll put down my California phone and pick up my Pennsylvania phone if I need to make a call in the right place. So the congressman, is, without taking a position on what the federal government should do, believe that we need to make sure at least this discussion happens on the federal level. And while many ideas and many, you know, it's good to have states as incubators, that doesn't always make sense when you have to have uniform national rules. That's why we have a Commerce Clause, and this would be an application of it. Actually, I had one of my Republican counterparts told me that this was the best application of the Commerce Clause he'd ever seen. And granted, the fact the reputation of my side of the aisle, I took that as a great compliment.